have new developments in that Amber Alert out of Springfield, Missouri, where the body of missing 10-year-old Hailey Owens has been found. A man is now in jail in connection with her murder.
We are moments away from a news conference involving Springfield police officers where we are going to get the latest on this particular story, a story that we've been following throughout the morning on KMBC 9 News. There is the man in custody right now. That's 45-year-old Craig Michael Wood, who is being held right now in the Greene County Jail on suspicion of murder. Let's go ahead and take this news conference live. The chief of police in Springfield, Missouri.
All right, good morning. Here to update you on the status of our investigation into the child abduction that occurred yesterday. We are now able to confirm that we have in fact discovered a young female body pursuant to a search warrant at 1538 East Stanford in Springfield. While she has not been positively identified, we have a high degree of confidence that it is our victim, Hailey Owens. An official finding regarding identity and cause of death unfortunately won't be determined until after an autopsy is performed at a later date. Throughout this investigation, we have kept the family informed of our progress. In fact, we let them know early this morning it was a possibility that we had, in fact, located a body. But at that point, we were not able to confirm the fact that this was our victim. SPD and FBI investigators are continuing to process multiple scenes related to this crime, including the residence at 1538 East Stanford, gathering evidence related to the crime in order to present charges to the prosecutor. Craig Michael Wood, 45, of Springfield, was arrested by SPD and booked into the Greene County Jail at approximately 11:30 p.m. last night. Investigators continue to compile reports, gather evidence in order to present information to Greene County Prosecuting Attorney Dan Patterson, who will determine what charges are appropriate and should be filed in this case. And I'll take questions you might have now.
What led you to him? Did you get a tip that he was at his home?
There were a couple of very good witnesses who witnessed the abduction, provided information regarding a vehicle and a license plate number, tracked that to the owner of the vehicle, and from that we were then led to our suspect.
Is there any connection between the suspect and the little?
There's no connection we've been able to determine at this time at all between our victim and our suspect.
You had witnesses see the crime. They were able to give you a license plate number, and from that time around 5 o'clock till 8 o'clock, is that when you caught up with him?
That's correct.
So in between that time is when we're thinking he killed this little girl. Is there
came together how it should when people are paying attention and vigilant and provide information. We processed that information as quickly as we could, got the information out. Very proud of the work the officers performed in bringing this case to feel it's a tragic, horrific conclusion to a conclusion in a very short amount of time when you consider cases like this. Together, officers doing what they're supposed to be doing, and ultimately finding the person responsible, we think, and taking him into custody.
Not to push, but so basically, people saw this little girl get abducted. You guys had a license plate number. Yes, you worked quickly. Within 3.5 hours, you had him. But that is saying that someone can see a child being abducted, and that child could still end up dead. How can you assure these people in your community that that won't happen again?
How can I assure people that bad things won't happen? I can't. Bad things do happen. The fact that people were paying attention and actually tried to stop the abduction from the reports I've read, took action, is to be commended. Could have been the opposite, that no one had seen anything and we would still be looking and we wouldn't have a clue as to who did this. I prefer to look on any positive we can draw from this and say we did catch the person responsible. Unfortunately, after a very tragic ending.
Can you clarify, was it 8:30 or 11:30 p.m.
We actually located the suspect in front of this residence at about 8:30 p.m. He was booked into jail at about 11:30 p.m.
Was her body found inside the home or outside the home? Was her body found inside or outside the home?
Inside the home.
Chief, can you tell us whether or not the victim was killed elsewhere or killed there at the home?
do not have that information. We are processing multiple crime scenes at this point.
You say multiple. Which, what are you talking about besides the house?
More than one.
Chief, is the Dutch made longer met on national crime scene related to this?
That's that one of the things we're processing, yes.
Have you ever handled a case that's been this difficult? I mean, we're talking about a 10-year-old girl.
It's tragic. It's horrific. And 30-plus years of law enforcement, I've dealt with a lot of things. No, I cannot specifically point to a case like this. An abduction of a young child by a stranger, and then the tragic ending, no.
Chief, yesterday a 911 report, to my understanding, came over about 3 o'clock in the afternoon at Watkins Elementary. A parent or somebody calling saying possible child abduction. It didn't happen, but is this related? Do you know anything about this?
I have no idea.
What can you tell me about why this happened? Was this a random targeting?
That's going to be up to our suspect, and we've interviewed him. Unfortunately, he's chosen not to talk to us, so we don't have the answers to those questions as to motive or why it happened.
What about the fact that this guy worked at a middle school?
He has a criminal history, I understand, some drug charges. I don't think there's anything else, Major.
A wildlife violation.
Okay, nothing related to something like this at all.
What about the fact that he worked at a middle school and apparently was around children all the time for years?
That is what I understand. He was an employee of Springfield Public Schools. Don't know anything about his employment there, and I would refer you to SBS to answer those questions.
Is there any indication that anyone else was involved in this crime?
Not at this point.
Any indication that she was sexually assaulted at all?
Do not know that.
Was it police who found the body inside the home?
Yes, ma'am.
What was Hailey doing when she was abducted?
My understanding, she was walking down the street, correct? Major?
Yes, sir.
Can you tell us more about what witnesses saw? You say there are multiple good witnesses. What did they tell you about what happened?
They had observed a vehicle in the neighborhood, circling the neighborhood, also observed our victim, and at some point, observed the vehicle pull up and have a conversation, the driver have a conversation with the young girl, and if I remember the reports correctly, she initially ignored and then came back and spoke with the driver, at which time he suddenly jumped out or grabbed her and pulled her into the vehicle. Our witnesses said it happened that quick out in the street, and then the vehicle sped off with her inside the vehicle.
Do we know if she knew him from his teaching position?
No indication at this point that they knew each other at all.
Can you address the actions of the witnesses? You said somebody even tried to stop the abduction. Can you explain that further?
A couple witnesses who observed it chased the vehicle on foot. Someone else actually got into a car and tried to chase the follow the vehicle and lost it while calling 911 and getting us to respond. So more than one person was involved in trying to stop this, and unfortunately it didn't happen.
And that plate initially tracked to Ash Grove, correct? Or the owner of the vehicle was able to tell you they had loaned the vehicle to this person, or?
We were able to find a registered owner of the vehicle who then directed us to who might have the vehicle, yes.
So is that some of the delay in that 3.5-hour window getting to Craigwood?
A delay? I'd prefer to think that's pretty quick to identify and arrest someone in a crime of this magnitude. It's a process, and gathering information, running down leads, and working through the process, yes, it took us 3.5 to 4 hours to do all of that.
Any message for child predators who are out in our community seeking to do these kind of things to kids?
A message to a potential predator? It's not going to be something... It's not something we tolerate. It's not something we expect to happen in our community. This is a very rare occurrence. I'm hopeful.
The fact that the community came together, it was very
encouraging over the last 12 or 15 hours to see the responses from community members, citizens, social media, the news media, the putting information out, and the concern that everyone has expressed for this little girl. I think we can take heart in that's really truly what our community is all about. He was found in the vehicle at the house, and yes, as far as I know, that is his residence.
And Hailey was in what grade at Westport?
That I don't know for sure.
Was he sleeping in the truck?
No, ma'am.
When you guys found him, he was just trying to this lady?
He drove up in the truck as officers were watching the residence.
Did he try and flee?
No.
Was there any kind of commotion, or did he, what happened? How did it?
No. Investigators contacted him, had a brief discussion, and he actually agreed to accompany them to headquarters for questioning regarding this potential crime.
Did he say anything at all? Did he confess in any way?
My understanding is he refused to talk and asked for an attorney once he was at headquarters.
Are there any unsolved child abduction cases that you may be looking at now as him as a suspect?
Not in our community that I'm aware of at all. We have been in contact with the National Center for Missing and Exploited Children, and we'll certainly be working with them to see if there's anything along those lines, but not that I'm aware of.
Any indication?
We have been watching a live news conference out of Springfield, Missouri, getting the latest on the apparent kidnapping and murder of 10-year-old Hailey Owens. This was the result of an Amber Alert, and it came to a very tragic ending when we found out that they had discovered the little girl's body.